cops don't rat on cops.
Lowell's been assigned to you as a partner.
No.
Yeah, it must be real tough for you knowing that everybody hates your guts.
Lowell, he nails a bunch of cops for being on the take. Chris, she turns in her boss for sexual harassment.
Are you saying that what Lowell and I did is the same thing?
Cagney, you're a sergeant. Now, I want you to pull yourself together and start acting like one.
Being a police officer is like being a member of a club. You have to play by the rules.
You guys got to try harder than that if you can keep me from being a cop.
I cannot work with this guy. He is dead weight. And I want him removed.
Yes, Inspector, I realize that there is nothing personal involved. No, I understand your position perfectly.
Good morning.
Think so?
So sue me, I'm an optimist.
Inspector, I don't really care whose decision it was. All I'm saying to you is I got enough problems here already without adding more.
No, ma'am, just hang on, please.
Yes, I am listening to you.
What's up?
They're all very capable. Well, I'm in the habit of making the assignments here.
What's going on?
It seems we've got ourselves a new transfer.
Yes,
Lieutenant's trying to do what he can to rectify the matter.
Is that him?
Yes.
Well, he looks harmless enough from where I'm standing.
Better check your eyesight, Cagney. That's Patrick Lowell in there.
The Patrick Lowell? Is he getting transferred here?
Say what you will about him, the man's got guts.
Guts? You call ratting on your partner's guts? Listen, I don't care if a cop peddles dirty pictures in church. You just don't go squealing on another cop.
Yes, we have.
Cops don't rat on cops.
It's not like I'm agreeing with what the guy did.
I sure hope not.
Cagney. Yeah.
Yes, Lieutenant.
Have a seat, Cagney.
Thank you. I'm fine right here. Thank you, Lieutenant.
Detective Lowell, this is Sergeant Cagney.
How do you do?
Detective Lowell has been transferred here from the 7-4 in Brooklyn. Seems they got an overload of staff there.
Matter of fact.
Yeah, seeing as we are understaffed here, the detective is going to fill the gap.
Lieutenant, if you don't mind, I'm due at the task force headquarters in about 35 minutes.
Cagney, Detective Lowell, if you don't mind, I'd like to have a word with the sergeant.
Not at all. And just go outside, try to make myself comfortable.
Cagney, you know that I've been on this job a long time now. Long enough to know that on occasion we have to do things that we may not feel too crazy about doing. What I'm trying to say to you is that there are times when we do things just solely, and I mean solely for the good of the department.
I understand.
Lowell's been assigned to you as a partner.
What? No. No. That's
save
not
yourself
right.
A migraine. Squawking against this one's going to get you nowhere.
Well, I'm a superior officer, and I should have some say about with whom I work.
Yeah, well, ordinarily, you would. It's just that in this case, Inspector Nelman thinks that you're the right officer for the job.
Oh, really?
Yes, and I happen to think that you're someone whose sense of professionalism far outweighs any personal feelings you might have. Bottom line is that Lacey's on maternity leave makes you the only one available.
What is this? Has Nelman got it in for me or what?
That'd be enough.
Oh, come on, Lieutenant. You know he's had it in for me ever since I brought Hennessy up on charges. And that's what this is about, isn't it?
Cagney, you're a sergeant. Now, I want you to pull yourself together and start acting like one. Now, there's been a series of stick-ups at the automatic tellers in the Wall Street area. I'm going to take you off of the task force, and I'm putting you and Lowell on stake-up. Here.
Why not? I mean, what, a $200 ATM mugging is much more important than a $4 million armed car robbery. Lieutenant, excuse me, please.
No, I got my phone white helmet.
Yeah, Bobby, you got a line on. No,
apparently. Let me give you a little advice. Don't get too comfortable.
4.7 million dollars lifted with hardly a trace from a Lodi armored car.
Yeah, my bet's on organized crime.
Let's bet on one thing at a time. You guys all placed your bets with Coleman yet?
Well, I heard Lowell had his locker set on fire at the 7-4 and still stuck it out 10 days. I'm putting down 20 that he stays 15.
Nah, it's gonna take longer than that. Barring any bonfires, it's gonna take 3 days for him to realize everybody hates him. It's gonna take 4 more for him to realize just how much everyone hates him. Probably another week for it to sink in, and then another week to get a transfer, huh? I think we're talking about 21 days here.
Coleman bet Lowell won't last a week at the 14th.
Huh? It's the 14th after the 7-4 dozen.
The start is yours, Becky.
Can you believe this crap? I get pulled off the armored car task force, the only glory detail of the month, you understand, and they put me on some penny ante money machine muggings. Breathe. In, out. In, out. Perfect. And then to top the whole thing off, I get Lowell as a partner, which, if you don't mind my saying so, Mary Beth, would not have happened if you and Harvey had controlled yourselves. Just concentrate on the focal point, okay? You know what it's gonna be like working with this guy, huh? There's not a cop in the city that doesn't want to spit in his face. Did you also know he was still in uniform when he pulled this stunt? That's right. Equal breaths, easy, equal breaths. That's it. Perfect. Oh, Mary Beth, I wish you'd just deliver so that I could get out of this mess. There. 60 seconds. All right. One last final cleansing breath. Perfect.
As I recall, this man blew the whistle on 6 police officers on the take. That's guys using their badge to line their pockets. I say they deserve to be weeded out.
I didn't say that they didn't. But how did Lowell do it? He broke ranks and he spills his guts to outside agencies? He went to the press!
Well, maybe he tried going through a department, didn't get anywhere. It happens, you know.
Well, maybe he should have tried a little harder. You don't have to hang the department's dirty laundry out in public.
Now, where have I heard that before?
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, that's the same line Nelman used. When you brought charges against Tennessee for sexual harassment?
Are you saying that what Lowell and I did is the same thing?
Well, I'm not saying it's exactly the same
thing. It isn't even close to the same thing. I kept my charges in-house, and you know it, Mary Beth.
Chris.
Where are my mittens?
I'm saying that you acted out of integrity. Maybe Lowell did, too.
I know they're here somewhere.
Christine, you showed that a police officer cannot be above the law. So did Lowell.
Found him.
Oh, Chris, come on.
That bastard went outside. And you know what really ticks me off? He got a TV movie and a gold shield for it. And what did I get? Flack from the brass. And now I have Patrick Lowell as a partner. There's the difference. Chris.
Is it cold out there? I know nature has no business calling in weather like this. Cinnamon. My wife Sylvia, ever since we moved to that country, she's got this thing about cinnamon and spices and natural stuff. Next thing you know, she's gonna put dill weed in my hot chocolate. You want some coffee? My dad used to work with Nat Cagney over in Flushing. Is he any relation?
My father's name is Charlie, and he's never worked in Flushing.
Oh, then you're a police brat, too. Huh? Boy, can I remember.
I don't want to hear about it.
Well, I don't suppose you do.
I read the papers. I see the news. I even saw your performance, the Davis Commission hearings. Lowell, I know all I want to know about you.
Okay. I get the picture.
Well, I'm going to skip yours. What's it going to be, a TV movie? About a cop wearing a crown of thorns who saves the world from 6 rotten apples?
For what it's worth, I turned the TV movie down.
The widow of the cop who killed himself. She'll be so glad.
All cars within the confines of the 14th precinct at 10:30. Possible mugging at the automatic teller machine. Delancey and Lafayette, northeast corner.
414 responding.
Then we see the guy laying out in front of the money machine, barely conscious and blood all over the place. And my buddy Ira, he thinks it's a drunk that's passed out. But I ain't never seen a wino wearing $100 loafers.
You see, you can't describe the car. And you didn't get their license plate, right?
No. Did you happen to get a clear look at any of the passengers?
Only the driver. It was a white kid, dark hair, and with one of those big purple thingamajigs on his face.
Strawberry Mark?
Yeah, right, right. Did I happen to see you a couple of months ago on TV?
Possible.
Next up, Hollywood. Thank you.
Hey, donuts. Donuts here. Courtesy of Willie Woo of Woo's Donut Shop. Who this morning became the proud father of an 8-pound baby boy.
Yeah. Bavarian cream. I hope he believes in large family.
That's okay. I'm a crawler man myself.
I appreciate it. Okay, thank you. Beat cop in Bay Ridge thinks he has a lead on the getaway driver. Punk kid that he knows. Fits the physical description. Matches the teletype. It's a Billy DeSalvo, 1412 Towner Street. You ready?
Oh. I'm sorry. It's a little accident.
When you clean yourself up, I'll be in the car. Is this a DeSalvo residence?
Yes.
You'd like to talk to Billy, please?
He's not here.
Do you know where he went?
No. Yes, he must be at work. His uncle has a garage, and he works with him, and he thinks that Billy has the makings for a real good mechanic.
Mind if we come in?
Wait a minute. He didn't do anything. I swear to God, he didn't do anything.
Hey.
Hold it right there.
I didn't do nothing, Gina, I swear. I didn't do nothing, I swear.
You know, I kind of hoped having a wife and a kid might help straighten Billy out. See, me and Billy, we go way back. First time I collared him, he must have been 11, 12 years old. About the same time he started running with the straight razors. How are you, Tony?
Any chance that he's still with him?
There's none of them left to be with. In fact, Billy's about the only one who isn't doing time in Attica.
Any idea who's running with now? I asked you a question. You know who he's with these days.
Billy with a gang now?
You know, we got about a half dozen gangs in Bay Ridge alone. Best bet would be to check with the youth gang division.
Okay, I'll do that. Thank you.
Listen, for what it's worth, you know, Billy's boosted his share of cars. He's even performed wheel service on occasion. But jumping people at money machines, it just doesn't sound like Billy.
Okay.
You've been very helpful. Thanks a lot.
Is he with you?
We ride in the same car.
Prepare yourself, children, for a home base that transforms 25,000 individual police officers into a single unified force.
Well, what do you know? The fabulous foursome, huh? Keeping the city safe in these poor defenseless armored trucks. How's it going?
It's a regular three-ring circus.
We'll see you back at the fort.
All right. Official word has it that terrorists are behind the robbery, so now all the teams are scrambling to pin the job on their favorite crackpots.
Yeah, the 2-9's got some black paramilitary leader, and the 101 is sitting on some Puerto Rican revolutionary. My bets are on the neo-Nazis or the KKK.
That's as spirit as Becky, huh? You cracked this case with the glory of the old 1-4. Me personally, I have a very exciting rendezvous with the youth gang.
Cagney, can I talk to your partner for a second? I just want to speak to you for a minute. Just wondering how things are settling in for you.
Oh, fine. Thanks for asking.
Yeah, it must be real tough for you knowing that everybody hates your guts and all. Well, what I'm trying to say is I've come to the conclusion you're not a quitter. I mean, what's the big deal that people treat you like a leper? You're a big boy. You make your own decisions. But I don't think you're the type to up and transfer just because of a little coffee.
So how much you bet?
What do you mean bet?
On how long I stick it out.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I hope you didn't bet too much. Because, you know, I tend to do the unexpected.
Bay Ridge. Bay Ridge?
Right.
Sorry, must have been misplaced. You try checking with the original precinct?
We just came from there. They said that all the files on neighborhood gangs are stored here at Central Headquarters.
Oh, believe me, they got their own copies. You show them a little muscle, they're bound to deliver.
You expect me to schlep all the way back to Brooklyn? I'm on a case here, all right? I don't want to play games.
Sarge, the file has been misplaced or thrown out, which is what should have happened to that partner of yours. The force doesn't need rats like him.
Officer, I want you to put on your bifocals and find me that file, or I'm going straight to your superior.
Okay, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll keep looking. And if you come back later without your friend, who knows, it may turn up.
Harvey? Am I typing disturbing your ball game?
No, honey, it's okay. You go ahead. This game is a sleeper.
Honey, you want me to bring you some popcorn or beer or something?
Mary Pets, if you don't want to type, no one is making you.
So bored, typing the same thing over and over again.
Oh, over and over. Now is the time for old blonde cops to come to the aid of their pregnant partner.
It was a change of pace.
I am sure Chris has a good reason for not showing up tonight.
Listen, if she doesn't want to do my breathing exercises with me, I'm not going to push her. She's just a backup. You're the coach.
You are planning to be there, aren't you?
Ringside seat, kiddo.
She called. She said she was working, but she's still mad.
Hey, whoa, I'm not going to let you blame yourself for this one. She wanted you to agree with her about Lowell, and you did not tell her what she wanted to hear.
No, worse, Hav. I compared her to him.
So what's the big deal? I mean, Lowell, he nails a bunch of cops for being on the take. Chris, she turns in her boss for sexual harassment. They both did what they thought they had to do.
Harvey, being a police officer is like being a member of a club. You have to play by the rules, especially the unwritten rule that says one cop does not bust another. You know, there's a lot of people still give her a hard time for what she did.
Sweetheart, you know what she did was right.
Oh, yeah. I was the one that was all for turning Hennessy in.
Chris doesn't do anything she doesn't want to do.
Right, which is why she's not here tonight.
Well, she's not, but I am. Now, what do you want to do? You want to type or you want to do Lamont's?
Are those my only choices?
Not if I can help it.
Yes, I realize you went to great pains to steal all that money. No, yes, I'll be waiting for your call. Goodbye, Mr. Tepper.
Well,
just another crackpot.
Marcus, we are working on a task force. We cannot afford to ignore anyone.
Victor, this man is offering to return the $4 million if his landlord gives him back his security deposit.
Maybe we should put him on the bottom of the list.
Okay, Billy, let's try it again.
What do you want from me? I told you everything.
Oh, come on. You don't really expect me to believe you pulled this job alone.
Makes no difference to me what you believe.
You think protecting the rest of your gang makes you a big shot, don't you? I think it makes you a sucker. That man. You know that man that your friends put in the hospital the other night? Well, he's in a coma still, Billy. The DA doesn't like having his citizens in a coma, so I think you're looking at some pretty serious time here. Right, we're talking armed robbery, attempted murder. Charges that ought to put your butt on ice for about 10 to 20 years minimum. For what? For whom? For them? Well, you wise up. All you did was drive the car. You can't be crazy enough to take this rap alone. Will you look at me when I'm talking to you? Maybe you're not crazy. Maybe you're just plain dumb. You've got a wife and a baby. Are you willing to trash them to protect these punks? What's Gina supposed to do between visiting days, huh, Billy? Supposed to sit home and grow old, waiting for your parole date? Me, I'm banking that she's not as dumb as her husband. I'm banking that she's gonna get herself a new old man in no time. Maybe Vinny, maybe Double D, maybe some other kid.
I think we ought to take a break here. And maybe Billy wants to reconsider having his lawyer present.
What the hell was that all about?
Kid's got rights, I just reminded
him. We gave him his rights, he waived them. I had him all set up to turn, and you deliberately screwed it up. Why?
From the 5 muggings, we got at least 3 reliable witnesses.
What is this, a soft spot for juvenile delinquents?
That kid squeals he's dead, and even if he survives, he's marked lousy for life. I just think he should be allowed to make the decision for himself.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. You're worrying about moral dilemmas, and a man is in a coma. What kind of cop are you?
Maybe not a very good one.
Just when it looks like the kid is starting to crack, Lowell opens his big mouth and he ruins everything. Yesterday, I had to drive downtown 2 times to get case-related info. The first time we were there, the detective said he couldn't find anything. Later, I drove downtown without him, and lo and behold, everything miraculously appeared.
All right, what's the point you're trying to make here, Cagney?
The point is I cannot work with this guy. He is dead weight, and I want him removed.
Damn it, Cagney. You think you're the only one around here who wants that? Nobody wants him out of here more than me. Nobody. So if I had my way, I... But I don't have my way. My hands are tied, Cagney, and so are yours. You got a job to do, do it.
Sorry, Lieutenant.
Cagney, message for you.
Thanks, Brandon.
You have a match?
Sorry, I don't smoke.
Word came through from the hospital. That guy your friends beat up. He just died.
This is a call you traced.
In the flesh, one Stanley Poe. Self-proclaimed urban terrorist and armored car owner.
What's this self-proclaimed bull? I am an urban terrorist. And I did rip off the $4 million.
W-H-A-T. What's what?
The whole of humanity against technology. You may not know us now, but we're alive and growing. And we'll keep on growing as long as there are demented souls who care more about machines than people.
Paul was an ex-toll collector, isn't that right, Mr. Paul?
22 years on the Bronx Whitestone Bridge. And they dumped me for an automatic coin collector. But I got even. I got their quarters back all right.
Bingo!
Ha-ha!
6 o'clock news, here we come, huh?
You got enough there to buy a whole slew of hotels on Boardwalk and Park Place.
Counselor, so what do you think? Does our detective look dangerous enough for you?
Well, he is younger than your other ringers, I'll give him that. Actually, he could look a little, scruffier.
Newman, would you mind unbuttoning your shirt?
Okay, but I'm not sure it's gonna make me look any scruffier.
Newman, you're supposed to be in costume. You've on a clean white t-shirt.
I know, but my mother told me the same thing your mother told you.
She'll understand, Newman. Excuse me a minute. Counselor, if you have no further objections.
Look, I don't mean to be picayune.
Not at all.
But I do have to make sure my client gets a fair shake.
As you should, sir. And I would like to get on with this lineup.
Of course. Hey, wait a minute. What about my earring?
Mr. Schimmel, is it possible that your client could see his way to removing it?
Forget it. I got a constitutional right to wear an earring.
An oversight of our founding fathers.
How do I look?
As foolish as you feel. Anyone else need an earring? Take a clear look at each face. Start from left to right, please. Do not stop at number one. Just go right across the line. But take your time with it. Clear your thoughts completely. And just concentrate on each face. Do you recognize any of these men? You, sir?
I'm sorry.
Look hard. Look hard as you can.
It's just that it was so dark and everything happened so fast.
No, try again. You've got to concentrate.
All right. Just wait a minute, detective.
I'm not going to stand by quietly while you lead these witnesses.
Mr. Schimmel, please. None of us want to do anything to jeopardize this lineup. Do we?
Now, take another look. You've seen one of those faces before. He threw you on the ground, he took your wallet and kicked you in the ribs.
Sergeant, I demand you put an end to this at once.
Okay, Dave, that's it.
I'm sorry we couldn't be of more help.
Thank you.
Next time, try a cattle prod. You might get better results.
Too bad my partner isn't here. I mean, my real partner. She's on maternity leave. She's great with guys like you. She bleeds and you hear music. I don't have any music for you, Billy. I only have hard, cold facts. This code of silence is a crock. A man died. You drove the getaway car. And if you don't talk, you're going up for murder. Now, do you think Double D and Vinny would protect you? So why are you protecting them? Here. Because you're scared. And they're going to keep you scared. Fear's the only weapon they've got. But if you stay silent, you stay in jail. I know you think that makes you some kind of hero. I think it makes you a jerk. Silence is not loyalty, Billy. At this point, silence is suicide. So what are you going to do? Are you going to stand up and do what's right, or are you going to keep your mouth shut and let those guilty creds walk the streets, you tell me? Applying pressure.
I see.
Don't you go applying it where it doesn't belong.
Oh, you got a double standard? One for perps, one for cops?
It's the same for you, isn't it? Perps and cops, I mean.
Why don't you give me a break?
I'm gonna get Billy's wife to talk some sense into him.
It's the last thing he needs right now.
The last thing I need right now is trouble from you. So are you coming or what?
Why don't you let him decide this for himself?
Because without Billy's testimony, those punks walk on a murder rap.
You can't force someone into an act of conscience.
Wish we had a choice.
I didn't want to let them in, really. I swear God, I didn't want to let them in. But they knocked the door open. You wouldn't know if you talk. So I grabbed Johnny and then we tried to run. And Double D grabs me by my shoulder and start belting me in my face over and over and over and like a crazy man.
Mother, make them pay.
He says he'll come back and get me if you talk.
The DA has agreed to reduce the charges against you, Billy. And he will recommend probation, and he will also keep you and your family in protective custody. All you have to do is testify. You want to get back at him? You want to get him good? And you know what you got to do.
Yeah.
Late this morning, aren't you, Cagney?
Hiya, Coleman. Let's see. Yeah, I suppose I am by some people's standards, but lucky for me, those people don't matter very much.
Well, you don't have to get so huffy about it.
When you work as late and as hard as I do, Coleman, you get to be huffy.
Well, it's a privilege to look forward to.
What's this? His idea of a short day? Where the hell's Lowell?
Haven't seen him. Or missed him.
He chalked in and out before I had time to finish my morning coffee.
Ah, maybe that's it. Every time he sees a coffee cup or even smells a pot brewing, just flies the coop.
Did you ask him where he was going, Newman?
You mean, did I talk to him?
Yeah, that's what I mean.
You forget, Cagney, that the squadron and your partner are not on speaking terms, never were, and never will be.
Wherever he went, I hope he comes back. I got more days and a lot more money bet on him.
I'll remember that, Victor. I'll tell him when I see him.
By the way, Cagney, congratulations. I hear you got the kid to talk.
Yeah, finally. What about you guys?
He kept claiming it was neo-Nazis.
Well, how was I supposed to know it was an inside job?
My condolences.
Turns out to be a couple of their own drivers and a shipping clerk. So here we are chasing every washed-out, fly-by-night terrorist group that never existed, and all the time the money is sitting in some warehouse in Astoria.
Well, who cracked the case?
Security guard. It seems the geniuses forgot to pay their $34 storage fee.
So the guard takes a crowbar to the locker, out pops $4 million.
Imagine anybody being that stupid.
Where the hell you been?
The hospital.
What's going on?
Billy was knifed last night.
Is he all right?
He'll live. This time, anyway.
He was supposed to be in protective custody.
Well, it wasn't protective enough.
It's all right.
What do you care? Got what you wanted.
Why didn't you call me? I'll leave a message when
you left. Hey, I took care of it.
Hey, Lowell, I know that you're a loner, all right? And you like to do things your own way. But the fact is, I am your superior officer, which means you keep me informed.
Oh, come on, what do you get so upset about? It's all over for you. You know, it's a couple of court dates, and you just have to wear a skirt those days.
You watch it, Lowell.
Oh, yo, you listen to me. It's ended for you, and for Billy, it's all just starting. The guy's a full-fledged informer now. And that means that he's got to spend the rest of his life looking over his shoulder, wondering if it was all worth it. It's a hell of a life, don't you think?
Wouldn't know.
Did you do this?
I tell you what I think of you right to your face. A rat in your locker? No, it's not my style.
Style? And this place ain't? You gotta be kidding, style? Listen, rats, they're nothing. Compared to what I've been through the last 2 years, you guys gotta try harder than that if you can keep me from being a cop. Because that's all I ever wanted, being a cop, you know? It was, for me, it was more than a job. It was an ideal. It was something to look up to, something to believe in. And the funny thing is, I still believe in it. Even after all these dead rats and your dirty looks and your silent treatment, I still believe in the job and everything it stands for.
You believe in it? You believe in it so much. Why'd you go to the press?
Why, you think I rushed into this? Huh? You think I didn't spend month after month after month getting jerked around by my precinct captain telling me to sit and wait while my charges are supposedly checked into, and a year goes by and they're still being checked into, and the guys are still stuffing their pockets, and my wife and my son are getting death threats on the telephone? Yeah, I spilled my guts to the press. And when they gave me that gold shield, I'll be damned if I hadn't earned it. Because I had. My whole family had. cop can't be above the law, he's got to uphold it. And I did what I had to do. I know that now. And I also know a cop ate his gun because of my testimony. I'll never forget that. And even if I could, I got people like you around to remind me. Police chaplain told me once, God forgives, cops don't.
In. Out. Nice and relaxed. You doofus! You already let it pass the 60-second mark.
Well, you were supposed to be keeping count, too.
Give me that stopwatch.
No, Mom!
Fellas, this is not relaxing me.
I'll get it.
No, I'll get it.
Both of you, go get it!
Michael!
Harvey, who's at the door?
It's me. Okay, if I come in?
Sure.
So how you feeling?
Trying. Harvey's working late and the boys are testing to see if I really want to be a mother again. How you feeling?
I'm holding on.
How's the case going?
One of the gang members beat up the kid's wife. So we finally testified, and then we were able to round up the others.
Good work?
Yeah, it seemed to be. Till Billy got knifed for being a stool pigeon. Yeah.
Why don't you sit down, Christine?
It's consequences, you know. Everything we do has such consequences.
Yeah, tell me about it.
I should have come the other night.
Yeah, maybe. But you didn't want to.
Well, when you start comparing me to Lowell, Mary Beth,
Chris,
I just...
I had no right to shoot my mouth off.
Hey, you're my partner. And you're my friend. And I do want to know what you think.
Not all the time.
No, not all the time. Do you think that people see what I did and what Lowell did in the same light?
In my opinion, Christine, turning in Hennessy took a lot of courage, but it's not the done thing.
Charlie says you never bust another cop.
Chris, you did what you thought was right. When we have a conscience, we don't have a choice.
I think we always have a choice, Mary Beth. I do. I mean, who's to say whether the choice we make is right or not, but... I don't know, in the end, maybe only God knows that. Yeah, she'd know.
I didn't mean to make you mad, talk about you and Lowell in the same breath.
I understand why you did what you did. And I've been working with him.
You want to stand why he did what he did?
Now, don't put words in my mouth, all right? You know, that makes me angry.
You're gonna lose your temper again or only your mittens?
Don't push it.
I'm glad you're here.
I'm glad you're glad. So where'd you put my stopwatch?
You know, I was getting worried that we were gonna have to find a backup for the backup.
Ready? We will start with one deep cleansing breath. Ready?
Why couldn't he just stick it out 16 more days? Damn personnel department.
When will they get him out of here? What's the difference?
What's the difference? This is the difference!
The 1-3 in Staten Islands. Photographic unit. 9 to 5. I know, I won't make chief of detectives, but I get to know my wife again. Yeah, I... Thanks. Me too. I'll see you soon if the throughway's not too bad. Bye, honey. Well, I guess that about does it.
Guess so.
See you around.